I was starting to talk to a lot of investors about fundraising from basically everybody I knew who might possibly know somebody. Got to speak to like dozens and dozens of investors, and I was rejected 49 or 50 times before I got my first yes.
Hey guys.
Welcome to Here.
Here is the video calling app, essentially. It's a big shared canvas where you meet up. You can do real-time things together. You can play games, share notes, draw on a shared whiteboard. Everybody sees the same thing, and so when you move around, both the other people in this like virtual room see you move. It's a very like natural human way to interact with people.
Jesse is in Brooklyn, I'm in Connecticut. We want to be able to work together, but we weren't working together in an office all the time.
Want to hear something crazy?
Yeah.
Did you know Brayden and Steele learned to sing?
They what?
They learned to sing.
And when we weren't actually in the same physical space, we missed that feeling of being together.
I met Seth about 6 or 7 years ago. We became pretty good friends. We have always wanted to find a way to work together. We were really addicted to this notion that like you can create a sense of being in a room with somebody else.
We really needed to be able to coordinate and collaborate with each other. All the video stuff that was out there today just felt like it was very one-directional. Me talking at Jesse, Jesse talking at me. We wanted the feeling like we were together, working together, collaborating in real time.
Yeah, we had a crazy idea, and Seth has a sketch of this shared canvas where everybody just like throws a bunch of stickers and graphs and appears on video. We kind of realized that we needed it when we couldn't see each other anymore, so we just started hacking it together.
Once somebody has equity in your company, you cannot get away from them. Jesse and I really, we weren't really focused on the money in the beginning. We just wanted to make something that people love and something that we found useful. We basically put together a quick and dirty financial model of these are the roles we think we need to fill.
The way it sort of shakes out is there are one or two, bigger investors who put in most of the money. And then there are people called angel investors who they tend to be not professional venture capitalists, but just like, is making these investments for fun or on the side.
If you're taking money from friends and family, you have to be, like, it depends on who you are and how you think about it, but either you have a great relationship with these people and you trust that if their investment goes to zero, you're still gonna be able to hang out at Thanksgiving.
I think we should create some examples of what these are actually gonna be like.
Oh, Jesse, you always make us do real stuff.
We ruthlessly prioritized all of our work and worked on only the most necessary stuff that would get us to the next step in the business. Almost all of our expenses are salaries and staff.
We're in the technology sector. It's a highly competitive sector. You want good people to work on your team. You got to pay them.
There was actually a bunch of unexpected free stuff that we got. You know, like the big tech, like cloud computing companies, they want you to invest deeply in like their infrastructure.
One school of thought is don't take out any salary at all until you have your business in a great situation and it's really profitable. I've done that before.
If we're lucky enough to have a successful outcome from this, then that's sort of, you know, where it ends up being worthwhile, at least from like a money point of view. If we had to draw how our business works, I think this is what we would do. If we think about the people coming into a room, of those people that get together, which of them go on and subsequently create their own rooms, and that is how our business grows, through word of mouth and through like organic adoption. Let's say three people in it. They're here for a work meeting. One of them has a terrific time, realizes that this is actually gonna be perfect for their tabletop role-playing game later in the week. So they create a second room, they invite their friends. Now, all of these users among them, we hope that two or three of them also convert, meaning they become regular users and they start using us for other use cases as well, right? And so what we're trying to do here is create a virtuous cycle, essentially, where every successful get-together or like repeated get-together spawns one or two others, right? And this creates a viral loop, essentially, right?
I'm in the car. I'm on my way to New York City. I'm in Williamsburg, parked. I'm walking over to Jesse right now. Here's a secret stash of stuff for him.
Hey! Hey.
What's going on?
Almost okay.
It's perfect.
Exactly.
It's really funny, when you look at this and you look at what the product is today, it's freakishly similar, that you can start with this little hand-drawn thing and then start making something that's so big. Something that's functional and lets you work, while at the same time being fun and being expressive.